Yeah, so thank you for coming to my recital. It really means a lot to me, especially since I've been talking about it since October, which is freaking me out, just thinking about it. I'm regretting that now. I'm thinking maybe I should have just told you all yesterday, and then went, like, come if you can, don't worry if you don't, all right, bye. But I really do appreciate you all making it out here, especially to my family who made it out, the long physical trip from San Diego all the way here. And thank you to all my friends. I know it's a long way emotionally to be here at the Emotional Center. I know, I understand. I promise I'll stop talking soon, but I just wanted to tell you one small story. I was talking with Cole Marsh a little bit ago about my recital, about being worried that I was doing like way too much or not enough with this, that people wouldn't take me seriously or wouldn't understand what I was doing or thinking that it would all be a wash. I mean, this is my senior recital. I'm supposed to go to graduate school for this stuff. I don't know if it's good enough. I don't know if people think it's a joke. I mean, some of these pieces, it's not like John Williams. I clearly don't look like John Williams. But, you know, he told me that my senior recital was supposed to be a reflection of me, and it was supposed to be what I wanted it to be, so this is what I want it to be. So, our first piece is Clarinet Caldera. This is my first ever commissioned piece. It was commissioned by Kenzie Stallings as a passion project. It's a piece that got to be played at Craters of the Moon up at Arco, Idaho. It's this national monument and preserve that displays like this incredible preservation of lava flows and this beautiful sagebrush. I was beyond honored to be approached by her to write this. I tried to encapsulate the progress of a volcano as it goes through the movements of an eruption. There are four main parts to this piece, so see if you can spot them. Beneath the chamber, red rivers through the vents, and eruption. So I was lucky to have Kenzie come all the way down from Arco to perform this piece, so please give it up for Kenzie Stallings.
Thank you.
the sound of my own voice too much. So this next piece is called Balaenoptera. It's the scientific name for whales, I think. I'm pretty sure. I wrote this a while ago, so my memory's a little, whatever. This collection's kind of a special favorite of mine. I don't remember why I started writing it, probably because tubas and euphoniums, they sound like whales, right? You hear a tuba and you're like, that's a whale. That's an undersea creature of some sort. We begin this kind of suite with the fanfare of the belugas, move into a lullaby for a blue whale before dancing along with the 52 hertz whale. Now, the 52 hertz whale is a real whale that sings at a frequency that no other whale can hear, and for the past 15 to 20 years, according to researchers, has been swimming all alone because of it. I wanted to kind of explore that difference between loneliness and solitude, and the kind of emotional difference between those feelings. So thank you to Bill Waterman and the Tuba Euphonium Ensemble for playing this piece, as well as premiering it at the International Tuba Euphonium Convention. That's crazy. Thank you to our players for playing this, and please give it up for the Tuba Euphonium Quartet. Thank you.
Thank you.
represented an animal other than a bird, because if you know what a flute sounds like, it sounds like a bird.
because I like telling little stories. I submitted my program to Dr. Alexander, who is my composition professor, if you didn't know, to just have him like go over my CV, have him go over like the pieces, the names, whatever. I looked at the edits that he made, and he highlighted one of the names. This was not originally titled Life in C Major, this was originally titled Marine Life. He highlighted Marine Life, and in the comment section wrote, this sounds like a PBS documentary title. Especially compared to your more clever titles. So I changed it. Thanks. I appreciate the criticism, because honestly, Marine Life sucked. Yeah, so Life in C Major is much smarter. So these are two very short pieces. I wrote these to get myself out of a writer's block, and I wrote them based on a couple photos I found online, which will appear sometime. These beautiful Marine Life photos, I had to find the photographer to try and buy them to use them for this recital. There was just one issue, I couldn't figure out what package to buy, so I went to email the photographer, but his website had a little blurb that said he was gonna be in a boat in the middle of the Pacific Ocean for a couple months. Which is wild, are you kidding me? So I emailed him, I was like, hey, I know you're in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, but can I use your photos, please, for my recital? He did eventually get back to me, and he said I could. So this is for Iko Jones, he's a really cool photographer, you should look him up. That's for that photographer, so yeah, thank you so much.
piece really quick. About this. You know, this next piece, it really means a lot to me. I have a really difficult relationship with music. It's really difficult for me to be vulnerable, if you can tell by all the jokes that I'm making. My music just never seems good enough, musical enough, expressive enough to get the point across. I don't want to waste any more of your time complaining, but I can't help but try and justify myself in my music, even if it just seems so... Colin?
Yeah?
Are you okay? What was that?
Oh, sorry. I was just,
Okay, Colin, I thought we cleared this up at home, alright? This is my senior recital, alright? I thought you said you weren't going to do this.
You're fine. You can continue your little speech.
Okay. Ignore him. I feel like I can never be good enough. Like, I'm always just so,
Average.
What?
Average.
Okay. Alright. That's great. That's fantastic. Stop. Shut up. Just shut up.
You'd be so lucky if I would ever let this go.
No. Quit putting words in my mouth, alright? Listen. Just... This isn't about you, okay? This is about me. This night is supposed to be about me. Yeah? Yeah? Right? Right, Patty? This is supposed to be about me? Okay, you're not helping! What's going on? I'm not as good as you, Colin.
That's what you think.
That's what I know, alright?
You have to let this line of thinking go. Explore and grow. Through tomorrow, start singing in your falsetto. Your solo in your show is just below the shadow of your glow. And don't you slow your roll until you're falling to and fro and fast and slow and stop and go and...
Shut up!
Oh, okay. As if I've never let this go.
Great.
Average.
Oh, abortions. Colin, what are you talking about? I'm fine. Just because I don't think my stuff is good enough doesn't mean anything.
Our mind sometimes plays tricks on me, so what you think may possibly be trickery, conceived by who we meant, let's not.
What are you saying?
Which was premiered last year. This piece is my baby. This is my child. It is the only baby I will ever have. It is the only piece of mine that I truly consider finished. The only piece I don't think I could ever add on to or improve, although I'm sure I could. Other than Dr. A, who I was studying under when I wrote this piece, I refused to show this piece to my other two professors I studied under, Dr. Swingle and Dr. O Yang, who, by the way, I appreciate all of them for all the knowledge they've imparted upon me in these past few years while I continually annoy them with this stuff that I continue to put on and embarrass the rest of the composition department. Anyways, it's not because I didn't trust their judgment that I didn't show this to them. It's more about my relationship with music itself, that kind of tethered connection. You know, sometimes it's like a steel rope, sometimes it's a string, sometimes it's a fishing wire, and sometimes it feels like a noose. I hadn't written anything in weeks back when I was writing this. I was going for walks, I was writing little stunted melodies, but nothing was coming to me. Then, one day, frustrated, I sat down, I literally looked up the phrase on Google, beautiful sad words. You'd be surprised, there's a lot of them. And it worked, I found anagapesis. Noun. That's probably how you pronounce it, by the way. I don't know. That's how I'm going to pronounce it. Noun. The loss of feelings for something which you once loved. Oh my God. So I sat down and I wrote. 2 hours, I sat down and I wrote on my computer until something came out. I brought it to Dr. A the next day and he went, this is way too difficult for one piano to play. But it would make a great piano duet. He did not say it in that tone of voice. To make an even longer story shorter, 3 weeks go by and the piece is finished. It's my favorite piece. I don't care what you think about it now, but I hope that you find some meaning in it. Even if it isn't music that you've lost love in, I hope that it gives you sanctuary some other way. So, yeah. I was hoping that gave them enough time, but moving a piano is a lot of work and I'm not helping. So, don't talk amongst yourselves. It's rude to the performers. I'm gonna sit down. I've been standing for a while.
Thank you.
just absolutely the worst set change in the world. I'm going to talk for the last time, because this is the last song. And I'm sorry for keeping you over the allotted hour, but I also appreciate you all being here. This is really great. Again, like, thank you all for being here. I can't believe people came. I can believe people came. I can't believe you all came. So, yeah, this is great. I will also be having a reception on the third floor with snacks and goodies for y'all for making it through all this. So, yeah. And there will be drinks and food, which should be enough for you. You're all growing students. So, anyways, while everyone gets set up, composition was not something I thought I was going to do until my sophomore year. And even then, I'm still kind of clinging to the idea of music ed, and I still want to get my doctorate in composition. I want to teach at a collegiate level. I want my music to be accessible. I want it to be fun. I want it to be enjoyable. I want my music to inspire people to love music again, to remind them why they liked music in the first place. It's such a human condition to create. Across all of human creation, we have music. We create music for the sake of creating music. No one asks birds to make music. They just do. It's a part of them. It's a part of me. There's no such thing as good or bad music. Except this. This is not good or bad music. This is cowboy music. Alright? That's cowboy music. No, no problem. So, I originally wrote a cowboy piece last year for a conglomerate of friends because I really love my friends. And I wanted them all together in a piece. This created a problem because they all played vastly different instruments. But I did it, and people enjoyed it somewhat. Which brings me to my next problem. People asked me to do another one. That's this. This is the other one. The issue is that I had to write it. And that's my job, I guess, now, which I shouldn't complain about. But still. So when I announced that I was doing a sequel to my previous cowboy piece, I didn't realize just how many people had seen or heard about it. Because when I asked people to come to my senior recital, they went, oh, you're the cowboy person. And I went, yeah, I also make other music, you know. Yeah. Cowboys is also stuff I do, I guess. But they were pumped when they heard about a cowboy sequel, so, you know, whatever gets people here. So now I have to live up to that. So, you know, I'll just tell you what I changed up. Less percussion, more speaking parts for Colin, because when have we ever gotten enough of him? And you know what? I've gotten a little more theatricality in this. Just a little bit. Just an inch. And by an inch, I mean a mile. Because if you don't know me, that's who I am. Theatrical, loud, in your face, strange, weird. But most of all, tonight, I'm a cowboy. Yeah. And then, now, we're going to get set up for you. And then you will all be free to leave, and you don't have to listen to my improv comedy show anymore. Just give us a few more minutes. We're all just gonna conglomerate around here, don't mind us. Don't mind the cowboys. I made them all dress up like this. I did not make him dress up like this. He does this of his own volition. Thank you.
No, I'm the sick one.
Okay. All right. For one night only, the musical cowboys will take on. Oh God. Oh, the great bank heist. Oh.
Last we saw our musical cowboys, we saw them face off against an unwieldy foe threatening their small, unassuming western town. They defeated him in a face-off at high noon, defending their home and their friends, becoming heroes in the process. We return now to their sleepy little town, to their quiet little lives. I wonder what they're up to now.
There's no good news to spread. Taxes have been astronomical. People are going bankrupt. The rich are becoming richer and the sheriff is sitting pretty. Our cowboys have decided to take matters into their own hands. Their plan to rob the sheriff's bank tonight, risking their very lives. Let's see if they can pull it off.
Thank you.
And bring them up there. So I'll be up there in a minute. If you guys want to, I don't know, chat to the Cowboys.
Or maybe, I don't know.
Also, you have to take a picture, I guess. Whatever. But I will have snacks up there. And also, I want to talk to all of you. So maybe, you know.
Let's go.
Fuck.